Hey everybody, it's Tom Barnes. This is the Chicago scene on the west side at Garfield Park at the Hatchery. Hatchery's home to a bunch of businesses. They have shared kitchen space for startup restaurants, including Coco Chili. You can get chili powder, you can get the sauce, or you can order food like jerk chicken. And doesn't jerk chicken sound pretty great when it looks like this outside right now? Think of the tropical paradise that it comes from. Anyhow, I'm gonna talk to Nakenya Collins. She's the owner of Coco Chili Restaurant and the powder and the sauce right now here on the Chicago scene. So let's head inside and say hi. All right, I've made it inside the Hatchery, and I found Nakenya Collins, owner, CEO, head person in charge of Coco Chili, both the powder, the sauce, and the restaurant, right?
Yes, did I get absolutely. All that? You did.
You've had a busy February. You launched on the first here at the Hatchery, your online business, your restaurant, everything, right?
Yes, everything started up on February 1st. It's been a long time coming. We finally got in this space, and we are ready to go.
And you're ready to go with some traditional West African food, is what you're saying, and other variances of food, right?
Yes. So we do Afro-Caribbean soul. So it's a fusion of different Pan-African or across the Black diaspora, basically. Foods that I love and enjoy. I enjoy various cultures. And so I incorporate my love of these different foods into the dishes that I recreate.
So before we get started, you were also a business coach for years. You still are a business coach. You were just talking about have about 13 phones that you have to manage a day. But in the middle of this pandemic, you decided, you know what? I'm going to put down the business coaching thing, not all the way, but just put it down for a little bit. And I want to start up a restaurant right in the middle of the pandemic. Tell me about that.
So when I originally had this vision, it was actually years ago. I absolutely love cooking. Cooking is one of my passions, but also helping people. And so when I initially envisioned what Coco Chili would be, I knew that I wanted to develop a social mission that allowed me to not only share my passion of delicious food, but also allows me to continue to help others to improve the quality of their lives. So yes, I'm still a business coach, still doing coaching in some capacity. I still have clients for my business coaching business, but now I'm starting to expand more by using food as the catalyst to bring people together.
And speaking of that catalyst, and the biggest client of them all is yourself, because you started with the sauce, right? And then you did the chili. Explain that evolution into the restaurant.
Yes, so again, I've been cooking forever. If you follow any of my social media, you will see a combination of inspirational, motivational quotes.
And which is the Instagram, social media, what is it?
Coach Nakenya, at Coach Nakenya, I'm at Coach Nakenya everywhere.
Got it, okay.
So you will see my motivational quotes, you'll see business advice and tips, resources, but you will also see a lot of dishes. I'm an extreme foodie, so I often go out to eat, but I also go home and try to recreate most of the dishes that I have tried if I've really enjoyed it. I'm a big fan of enviable experiences. And so I love jerk chicken like most folks do who have had really authentic, delicious jerk chicken. And so that was one of the dishes I started to make very early on. It became a favorite amongst my friends and family. And because I use fresh herbs and spices in the sauce and the marinade, it smells amazing when it's being grilled to a smoky perfection. And it's so funny because when I used to grill it in the neighborhood, one time a man actually stole the hot meat directly off the grill, stuffed it down his shirt, took off running down the alleys.
Only in Chicago,
it's
right?
Really amazing.
And you make this from scratch right here. Absolutely. At the Hatchery in your little incubator space that you have, from just the spices to, you said, the Vitamix in and comes out the sauce, and even the powder that you use, the Coco Chili powder, right?
Absolutely. I use a combination of different chili and chili powders, as well as some other herbs and spices to create my Coco Chili spice blend. And then it gets incorporated into my Coco Chili, which is really delicious.
I can attest for it. Tried some a little bit ago.
But I also use that spice rub on other things, which will be coming to the menu soon, like my lollipop lamb chops, which will be rubbed with the Coco Chili spice blend.
And this wouldn't be possible without the help of your family, right? It's a family affair. You have your son and your brother, and who might argue, but do the heavy lifting of the cooking operation, and it's your vision, right?
Absolutely. So I'm very much an analytical and operational person. So even though I like to get my hands dirty in making the sauces and everything, they follow my recipes to the T. And this has always been meant to be something that could be a legacy for my family. I already have a six-year-old or seven-year-old grandson. I think he just had a birthday. He's a seven-year-old grandson, and he loves to cook. So he follows me around in the kitchen. So I envision being able to pass Coco Chili down through the generations and always having it a place where my family can call home, but also the community that we serve.
Speaking of the community that you serve, why don't you tell people what you guys do at the end of the week with some of the donations that you've received or that you offer up?
Yes. So I love to help other people, and I never wanted to just totally lay down coaching, but I wanted to use my love of food as a catalyst to bring people together. And so one of the ways that I do that is through our social mission, which is to expose our community to unique, sustainably sourced educational foodie experiences. And that allows me to do things like feed the community. So we have an initiative called hashtag feed the community, where at the end of the week, we take donations that we've received from patrons, as well as we add in our own funding in order to stock some of the love fridges in the local area.
And for people who just can't get enough of the powder, they can order that right off your website, along with the sauce too. It comes in a nice fancy jar for people, right?
Yes, we do have 12 ounce and 16 ounce jars of the sauce available on our website. It's actually connected through the Illinois Products online marketplace. We are a designated Illinois product, so we're very proud about being accepted into that program. So you can absolutely go into that marketplace to purchase the sauce and the Coco Chili Spice Blend.
That's fantastic. And for people who just want to order the food, they want to get to the restaurant part, the vision is to have the brick and mortar restaurant. But until that time comes, where do people go to get your food?
You can absolutely go to our website at cocochili.com. That's cocochili.com, cocochili.com. And on our website, you can order ahead for pickup or delivery through DoorDash.
And I'd be remiss if I didn't mention the PR company that kind of introduced us. And why don't you talk about that really quick? Because I've worked with Nikki and the folks over there for a long time, but why don't you talk about how they have helped you and how we've connected and other opportunities like this?
Absolutely. So I am no stranger to PR, having been a business coach for the better part of 25 years. And so I understand how important public relations can be to a fledgling business like mine that's just getting started and wanting to raise brand awareness. And it just so happened that as I was getting ready to launch, I saw the news mention PR for Good, and that they were looking for women-owned businesses, small businesses that were looking to launch. And I said, this seems like the perfect opportunity for me. So I filled out their online application, and lo and behold, they've selected me as their first client of the new year. So I was very excited about that. And the relationship has been amazing, phenomenal. They have connected me to so many different resources, amazing people, people like Tom. So I'm very excited about that. And it's just allowed me to really grow and expand probably faster than I would have been able to on my own.
Kenny Collins, it's been a pleasure talking to you, and your food is amazing. I was lucky enough to have some, and I appreciate you letting me try some. It's phenomenal. So keep up the good work, and we'll look for that brick and mortar restaurant sometime soon.
Absolutely. Thank you so much.
Sure. Yep, great things happening here at the Hatchery with Coco Chili restaurant, powder, sauce, the whole thing. Nakenya's amazing. I suggest you check her out. TBARNAS at WGNTV.com. TBARNAS at WGNTV.com. If you have a suggestion for the Chicago scene. Until then, I'll see you later. Thanks.